Hello everybody, good evening. I believe that our week has been wonderful. You are welcome to another time of prayer, and it's always an exciting time in God's presence. It's always a time to just unburden. It's a time to bask in the glory of God, in the aura of His presence, and it's something that is a rejuvenation therapy. The presence of God is a rejuvenation therapy where you just come and you gain strength. You know, the activities of life can so weary you, can so weary you, can so so much drain strength from you. It's not as though you are doing something bad, but by the mere fact that you are exerting strength into your job, exerting strength into your purpose, exerting strength into the ministry, into the church, into every aspect of your life, you are releasing energy to be able to do the things that you do, to be able to get the results that you get, and therefore you need a constant supply of strength. And one of the places, or the major place you should get your strength, is in the presence of the Lord. Do you understand? He says that they grow from strength to strength, as many as appear before God in Zion. So when you come before God, it's a time to gain strength. It's a time to allow God to renew your strength. He said that he would enable us to be strengthened in the inner man. That was the prayer of Apostle Paul, that you may be strengthened in the inner man by the Holy Ghost. So Apostle Paul understood the need for strength. He understood that every person needs a constant renewal of strength. He said, "They that know the Lord, they that do know the Lord shall be strong, and they shall do exploits." So the times that we have in God's presence together on this platform are times of extreme strength renewals. And you are welcome once again. Last week we started on the topic for this month, probably. I titled it Running with Ruth, and we started by gleaning from the story of Ruth, and then we are mapping out prayer points that pertains to our lives and destinies, because Ruth, like I said last week, Ruth is a special kind of woman because she came from another tribe and she walked her way into the genealogy of Jesus. She was a Moabite, but yet she walked her way and became part of the lineage of our master Jesus. So she was not an Israelite, she was not from the tribe of Judah, yet she became a part of that line, of that royal line. So we are trying to learn from her. So today we are going to chapter 3, and we'll draw two prayer points from that chapter, Ruth chapter 3. And the first thing we'll be praying for is for the force of obedience, and then the second thing is that our helpers will not rest until they help us. Do you understand? So in chapter 3, those are the two striking things that I saw and that we'll need to pray about. But before we do that, it's always good. David said, let's enter his gates with thanksgiving, enter his courts with praises. Do you understand? So there is a protocol when it comes to prayer. That's not to say that you can't pray without thanksgiving and without starting with thanksgiving, but it means that the protocol that David found out that worked for him was to enter his gates with thanksgiving, and to do what? To enter his courts with praises. So we are going to do just that. The scripture will say, bless the Lord, O my soul, bless the Lord, all that is within me, bless the Lord and do not forget his benefits. So what are those things that you are grateful to God for? What are those things that God has done for you, for your family, for your children, for your parents, for in your job, in your marriage, in every aspect, in your academics? Are you grateful for those things? Because sometimes it's easy to forget the benefits of God. It's easy for our souls to be so overwhelmed with the present circumstance that we forget the past victory. So the psalmist was making a call to his soul. He was saying, my soul, I know it's possible for you to forget, but I am commanding you, do not forget his benefits. Do not forget his benefit. He's the one. Kadesh, Eka, Terusia, Eguante, Zesudia, Ereshunua, Ekai, Dos Imparusia, Regedenus, Eka, Genos, Esupretia. He's the one. Aliado, Resuso, Preteria. He is the one. Jega, Resunia, Adunene, Kobeneka, Desunsenaha, Leko, Berus, Inteneka. You are the one, Father, that our souls have found anchor in. You are the one that we have found stability in. You are the one, Manosia, Ecobres Unse Prede Candeligado, Resuso Pretia, Enosia. And we have come to say, Father, we thank you. We have come to say, Father, we give you the praise. We have come to say that our hallelujah belongs to you. Our hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, Jerus Embrenos Ingamanaterus Evarata, for the blessings with which you have blessed us, oh Jeka, for the profit things you have given unto us, for your very own life that you've bestowed into us, for your spirit that you've put in us and upon us. We give you the praise, we give you the glory. Our hearts are joyful, our hearts are full of gratitude, our heart will rejoice in the things that you have done. Peresune kopelenaja resuso pretena kamanateze lokombrisonte resune Koberia Kopala Tose Embeneka Unebenda Zunia, for the Lord has done great things, whereof we are glad. Oh Jene Menosia, he says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dreamed. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongues with songs of joy. We singing, oh resono meko penenija, eko beredo zenemaha, eloboronte zene kamanata. You are the one that have delivered us. You are the one, Banteleka. You are the one. You have the one. You have sustained us. You have wrapped us in your embrace. You carry us in your hands. Oh, in your mana, Kenedo, Jerusalem, Mande, Gebedo, Zenika, Resunebeka, Liadon, Zenequatene, Impacumbri, Soto, Beka, Liadon, Zenekale, Russe, Bretono, Mocombica, Deze, Rus, Avanata, Icopelene, Jerusiata. You are the lion and the lamb upon the throne. You are the root of Jesse. Oh, Jeniko, Menetale, Rusieto, Menekam, Benenesuno, Maragadea. You are the lion and you are the lamb. You are seated upon the throne. You reign over all situations. You reign over all circumstances. You are seated upon the circles of the earth. Oh, Jesus, we worship you. Glory, glory to the Father. Glory, glory to the Son. Glory, glory to the Spirit. Alekandes kopreteila kabaradasha. Represude ketene peruka britandes kiberenosia. Resude kalikandes ketomono kombelekandia. Jigaderu azize frete. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. Genorus en sebrodo barakandele tombros ovreteneha. Menene jekoto bresi brodo balata. Jesus, we worship you. Jesus, we worship you. Be thou exalted, ancient one. We declare all the things. Oh, there is nothing we have that we have not received from the Father. There is nothing we have that you have not given unto us. For we know, we understand that every good and every perfect gift comes from above, comes from the Father. My Father, the Father of all lights, the Father of all spirits, comes from you, O God. For the protections, for the liberty, O men God, the Ruseino. Beg one day, Zerus and Lagoa, Lega, Lebenosia, Icoberano, you have led us day by day. Oh, Genemento Zenaka, and you have brought us in Geperanosia into our broad place. Oh, Jerusalembacanderopranaba, you have made lines to keep falling onto us in pleasant places. We are not ashamed. We do not belong to the company of the ashamed, we belong to the company of the unashamed. Oh, je caperus en venetante canderus e predegapa, resuso predecapalatus embrena cabaha, resundo pragatante kens untepelaka. Jesus, we worship you. Be thou exalted, Father, in the name of Jesus. We have worshipped. Amen and amen. So I will just pick out the first verse from Luke chapter 3, and then we'll pray, then we'll move to the second verse and second prayer point. So Luke chapter 3 and verse 5. It said, then Ruth answered, I will do what you say. I will do what you say. So we see Ruth interacting with her mother-in-law, and in this chapter, the mother-in-law told her some things. Say, this is what I want you to do. This is the time of threshing of the wheat. You know, Boaz will go to thresh the wheat. Go to the threshing floor, look for where he's lying, and then lie at his foot. And Ruth, the scripture said, and Ruth said, I will do all that you have said. So even though she may not have understood the import of what the mother-in-law was telling her, because sometimes instructions come from God, instructions come from authority figures that you may not understand, but the place of obedience in fulfilling your destiny cannot be overemphasized. So Ruth may not have understood the import of that statement, of that instruction, because she was not an Israelite. She does not know what it means. You know that someone is your relative, and you know your husband is dead. Go and lie at his foot at the threshing floor. So she may not have all those details. She may not have all those dynamics, but she had a heart of obedience that she was able to tell her mother-in-law, "I will do all that you have told me." There was no argument. I say, I will do all. So when it comes to fulfilling your destiny, you must have a heart of obedience to the instructions of God and to the instructions of the authority figures that he has placed over you. You know, it was the mother of Jesus that told the servants, everything, anything he tells you to do, do it. And Jesus gave them an instruction, fill up the water pot with water, and they did not argue. They did not say, water, we are looking for wine. Why are we filling with water? I said, they obeyed. They filled up the water jars with water. And then the miracle of turning water into wine occurred. So we are going to pray and say, Father, Omakande, Siko para, Tiesunegante kande, Conti vetukwa, reach also prena and kadia. It is my heart, Lord, that I am praying for tonight. Genunde, Resuzeka, Lesude Falandia, Jekoto Beka, De Rusia, Mente Akwate, that you would give me a heart of obedience in the name of Jesus. Oh, Genazia, Jeremiah speaking, he said, and the word of the Lord came to me and said, go into the house of the potter, and I will show you something. Jeremiah had the prompt obedience, and the scripture says that he went to the potter's house and he saw the potter working on the jar pot. So I did being Jeremiah was not obedient, did not have prompt obedience, he would not have obeyed that instruction of God, and what he saw, the lessons he learned, would not have been learned. And you say, Lord, help me, give me a heart of obedience to Oberus Iganaha. It says, when your obedience is complete, you'll be ready to judge every disobedience. Oh, Jekatitos Ekuberusia, Resuse Katia Enzudefante Kwale Kritos Ivarante, Jekute Ikapanaswa. So the things that the devil is doing in your life, God is saying, when your obedience is complete, you will be able to judge le parousia e compelata ecosia tenia. In the matters of destiny, obedience is important. Speaking of Jesus, the scripture says, verus inkepana resuse brete gadaha lene jeka ikabanata. He said that he learned obedience by the things he suffered. Oh, genus ezito menaha. And when he has learned completely, he says, and when his obedience was complete, he said he became the author of eternal salvation. So Jesus did not become the author of eternal salvation until he was complete in obedience. Resusegana, Jesus did not enter his destiny, the fullness of his destiny, until he had this element of obedience worked into his members. Le resuse kaba, resute kaliga, utene kubalata, resute varandia, eko zezeti enum panante, elakua genoria zezofrito menangatuze, resunia, that the Lord will help your heart, will help my heart. Oh, jeta, to be prompt to his instructions, in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you something now. The place you are you are currently at the level of your obedience. There are some instructions that God has given you that had even you obeyed it 1 year ago, you would not be where you are currently. So the place, your current location, your current phase in life is dependent on the amount of obedience you have given to the instructions of God to you. Do you understand? So can you go one more time and say, Father, pele su de kande, shieko parania, there are some instructions that you have given me that I have not been obedient to. Father, help me, King of Glory, to be obedient. Help me to develop a heart of obedience. Even the instructions that I don't understand. Abraham did not understand the instruction that said, go and sacrifice your son, your only son whom you love. He did not understand that instruction. It did not make sense to him, but as long as he was God, as long as he was coming to God, he obeyed. We must get to that point of obedience where any quadesia, as long as it's from God, whether we understand or not, we are prompt to obey. Jesus, help us. Bela suye egadan de ruse namanta le rusye kebakwade reprenos ikabalakwandesha. Hey, Jesus. Help us, oh God, balate, resudega, ikabala nama, jekete kete kete, inkopete lekete ne mendo, jiga dados entene bedua, resudege debe gede deke dele kombrus umbruto bogodo, rekete ikopana kadisha. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen and amen. The next prayer point for tonight will be taken from Ruth chapter 3 and verse 18. Ruth chapter 3 and verse 18. The scripture, you know, after Ruth obeyed the instructions, went to the threshing floor, you know, lay down on the at the feet of Boaz, and then Boaz woke up, told her some things. There's another relative. Let me see if he's going to perform what he's meant to do over your head. If he does not, then I will take it up. I will do it. Now, Ruth came back and reported to her mother-in-law, and Kabalatejia Kadaba. God just reminded me that after Ruth obeyed and did that, in the morning Boaz gave her a vase of flour. So her obedience started yielding from that moment. So God is saying to someone, there is an instruction that is lying fallow. God is saying you will begin to reap that which you desire when you obey that instruction. So Ruth obeyed that instruction, and as it were, immediately she reaped the harvest, a part of the harvest. Let's move on. Ruth chapter 3 verse 18. So Ruth narrated to her mother-in-law, this is what happened, this is what Boaz said. Now look at the statement of her mother-in-law. Ruth chapter 3 and verse 18. Naomi said, daughter, be patient until we hear what happens. Now, he said, Boaz will not rest. Kade, kade, kade. That statement is heavy. He said, Boaz will not rest. Kai, shigadosia. Until he has finished doing what he should do. He said, Boaz will not rest until he has finished doing what he's meant to do. Boaz will not rest. Boaz will not rest. Boaz will not rest. Kai shagada bagandeske beleka. The next prayer point is that we are going to be praying that the people that God has assigned to us to help us will not rest until they have done what God wants them to do for us and in our lives. It was the scripture that was speaking of a king that was restless in the night. He was restless in the night. He could not rest until he called for the book of remembrance. And he said, has this man beheld for this thing that he did for this king? And they said, no, he has not. And he did not rest until Mordecai was honored. So we are going to be praying, saying, Father, Ekwa Eshia, Detsidu Felaka, Resudie Kabangwa, Jekade, Tesunieka, every king that you have ordained to help me, I declare no rest unto him or her in the name of Jesus until he does what he should do. That was the statement of Naomi. He said, Boaz will not rest until he has finished doing what he's meant to do. Can you begin to pray that your destiny helper will not rest until they have finished doing what they are meant to do? I begin to declare no rest unto my destiny helpers in the name of Jesus until they perform that which God wants them to do in my life. They will not rest in the name of Jesus. They will keep moving. They will keep going from place to place in order to help me. They will still keep on seeking for my good in the name of Jesus. Pelorusie gebunde gadire zuruvre sugiate resude lo panagie de gotoja. Boaz did not tell Ruth. Tell your mother-in-law to go and meet this particular relative. Is the one that's meant to do this thing. It's not me. No, he said, I will go and ask him, and if he does not want to do it, then I will now do it. Oh, jekada bunte resude kabala kwende rizana reproduce nguate gudwa igotonega roprene pelos ye resude benete jaga ego peneka de rus entenema ropreden kopela jekoto kopela kwada Redentos anaboakada. Oh, Jekandepele, let me tell you, every one of us, we need help. Every one of us, we need the help of man. Even Jesus said, the scripture speaking of Jesus, said that he obtained favor. He had favor with God and with man. So Jesus obtained favor from men. Do you understand? So you need the favor of man too. Even as you have the favor of God, you need the favor of men. You need your destiny helpers. He said, and I will raise unto you 7 shepherds. And principal men and 8 principal men. Do you understand? So you need men raised up for your sake, and it's one thing that men, that they are meant to help you and they are not doing it. Kabala Kambreni Shakalia. Go again one more time. Barusev Frontier, that my helpers, they will not know rest. See, it's not knowing no rest, like there'll be trouble, things will not be working out well for them. No, it's that you are continually in their hearts. That's what it means. It's not that there will be trouble in their life until they help you. Mm-mm-mm. That's not what we are praying. We are praying that we will continually be in their hearts. We will continually be in their heart. They will always be thinking about us until they do what they are meant to do. So we will occupy their hearts. Kanejia gada 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 ha ha. Reside de getenebo comberia de Rusie compekwa denzidu de reshua de ekude la kwa resude gebendus iga du ruseveria de lemba ujia resusie kope lo baradie sude gra ekwa nemenuje lunde resuze ekia pelushie guaga repredos ensia kabalada. Oh, jete beke beleba. My heart, my picture occupies the minds of my destiny helpers in the name of Jesus. Lemenesha, my name, Barusiveria, keeps on popping up in their hearts. Elete, resuso brete copelene, jia go prederiga deha, resuze venemosie kaiko beledendoro predebeleto, resuze venemenos gede ben comberida jiari, redede de benuje gede legedelega. Oh, Jedebekaya, oh Jedebekaya, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus, thank you Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. These are prayers that you may want to continue praying. These are prayers you may want to keep on praying. So do so as you are led. Keep on praying that your ayah Iya, Iya. It's not all about that this is the man that is meant to help me, that God has ordained to help me. Is that this man, my name is continually in his heart. So he's always thinking, okay, what do I do for him now? How do I help out in this issue? So I'm not forgotten. Even the scripture says, and God remembered Noah. So until God remembered Noah, Noah was locked up in that ark. Until God remembered Noah, and it was not as if God forsook Noah. It was just that Noah came up in his heart. He said, and God remembered Noah. May your destiny helpers remember you today. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we thank you. Shana Mandes. We give you the praise, King of Glory. In the name of Jesus. Kamina Shia. Every promise of God to you, I declare you begin to see the manifestation. In the name of Jesus. Ekaida Jekania. Every barrier that the enemy has placed before you, I declare that you crush them in the name of Jesus. Every limitation, everything hindering your manifestation, everything hindering the manifestation of the promise of God in your life, I rebuke them now in the name of Jesus. Kai keparoshiana tetezia de combrinicia de lerusi vrenicia ganti zosocrinia. Be encouraged. And a shude kamani zerufresie to veneka. I see diamonds coming. Penendicia de rusivretie compena. A diamond represents something precious, something precious, something precious, something precious. Kaha le benemen shotokoton de kibere sobrotoko peketenke tenke telia rushie keperedo resute venia do pe ingo peliata. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you for joining tonight. You know, we pray every Saturday by 10 p.m. GMT plus 1. Thank you very much. And do have a lovely night rest. Bye. Bye. Mm-hmm.